Robert here from Whitehead Pump Repair. What's up? I'm gonna open this up now. You want to use like something like a razor knife. Be careful. You want to just open the top of the box up just like this. Okay. Use the knife away from you if you can. Turn it around just like that. All right. Let's see what we got inside, right? So we're gonna pack it here. And as we unpack it, we're gonna show you the different parts of it. This right here is the lid for the pump. This actually goes on top of the pump and keeps the water in. And then you basically have your generic packaging. I'll get that out of here. You have your handy dandy owner's manual from Hayward's. So I'm gonna take the pump out of the box, just like this. Here is the pump.
Oh my God.
There you go. Remember one video here, buddy. So here's the new pump. It comes with a standard 110 cord, just like that. So this is called, once again, the Hayward Power Flo LX. You can buy these models with, and you can put timers on the back of these. So if you want to have them shut off, turn on and off. In other videos, you will see that we're going to show you how you can basically take a basic pump just like this, buy a timer, and we're going to show you how you can wire a timer right to the back of it, because Hayward actually doesn't sell an external timer on the back of that. You know, when you shop around on Amazon or, you know, eBay, you might see the same pump and be like, why is this pump $300 compared to, you know, the one that's here, that's $200 in this bottle? And it might have a timer on there, but it might be more money, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Okay, so this is the lid. You know where this goes?
No idea.
Right here, let me show you. Robert, you, so basically, this is, see the notches here? See those notches?
Yeah.
See, if you take those notches, move them this way. If you see those notches, if you not see the notches there, see, it just goes on like that, see? It fits in those notches. And then what you want to do is push it on and turn it just like that. And then when you turn it off, just like that, yeah. Give it a whirl. So, okay, also now, once you take this cover off, once we show you how to do it, just remember to lock it in. Now, they may also make a little lubricant. Hayward makes a lubricant, and a couple other manufacturers do as well. You can put a little lubricant here, almost like a Vaseline, because in the summertime, what's gonna happen is this is gonna get hot, and especially being black, it's gonna heat up, and it might get sticky. It might be like, ah. And in other videos, we're gonna show you how to actually take this cover off and stock, and stuff like that. Now, inside the pump, you might see something else here. A little basket. See that? That's pretty cool. Now, you're not gonna use this to like, you're not using this to scoop the pool. Basically what happens is, let's explain something else to you with this basket over here. This front of the pump is called the inlet of the pump. This is where water is gonna go into the pump, okay? So basically you're hooking this up to like your skimmer, you know, like the skimmer you see in the pools?
Yeah.
You ever see go in the pool and you see a skimmer?
Yeah.
Right, the skimmer basically, that hose from the skimmer goes in here and this feeds the pump water, okay? And then it goes through here. And in other videos, we'll show you how the impeller works and everything inside here. But basically the water comes in through here, it goes in through here, and then it gets swirled around at high pressure and pumps out the top. Now, think about it. If you have just a skimmer in a pool, what can basically happen, even though you have a skimmer basket, say when you go to clean the skimmer basket out, you forget to put it in right away and the pump kicks on. What could happen is water and dirt and debris can go in here and then clog up the impeller, which is almost like a boat propeller, but it's internal. That could get clogged up with debris. So what you have is you have the skimmer basket. It's basically, you put it just like this, opening, obviously, matches up with that. See, just like that. And then basically anything that comes in here, as it comes in, will get caught up in here. So now you want to empty the skimmer basket once in a while, and we'll basically show you in pump maintenance videos. So basically like that. So now pretend like, so basically if someone says, hey, you might say someone, you know, you have a trouble putting, you're watching this video and you stumble upon it, you're like, hey, this wasn't exactly what I was looking for, but my pump is clogged, and you didn't know you had it back in here, that was something back. So really what you want to do, if you've just purchased this pump, and you haven't installed it yet, and you're replacing it with another model, or you're just replacing it in the pump, what you really want to do is put a valve here, and a valve here. And I'll show you that to you in other videos, because if you put a valve there and there, what happens instead of water rushing in, you can shut those two valves, and then open this up, cover right up like this, and then water will flow out. But basic above ground setups, they don't have valves. So when you go to, like, people are, you know, they empty the regular skimmer basket, what's on the hole, and they're like, oh my God, I'm gonna do this here. And then all of a sudden, you know, you open this valve up like this, and the cover up, like, then what naturally happens is water starts pouring on the motor. Some people, they pour so much, the motor won't start up right away. You know, you can really ruin the pump then, because as you know, depending on what model of the Hayward Power Flo you have, it costs between $200 and $400. Burn out a motor because of two simple valves. You know? Because you can get two simple valves, a $20 valve, $20 valve, or less, 20, depending what kind you go with. You go with a ball valve, or, but I would do something nice. Because you know, this pump right here can last you 20 years. And then your electrical connections, back here, if you're gonna have your electrician come, and if you don't use a standard 110 plug like this, because some pools don't use a standard 110, they actually just use like they have safety lock connections. You could have your electrician unwire it here, or you can do it yourself if you're handy. We can show you that in other videos about how people do that. But you really should be licensed electrician if you do that, because it's kind of dangerous. But this does come with the standard 110 cord that you if you do have a standard plug. All right, so the Hayward Power Flo LX pump can be bought online. You can visit the store. And it's a good solid pump for above ground pools. If you have any questions, let us know in the comments section, and we'll be more than happy to answer for you. Until next time, take care. Bye bye.